Welcome back. We just had Cheetos and they're stuck in our molars. Welcome to TwoLees channel. I'm Shelley.
And I'm Ashley.
TwoLees! We are doing a series on what it means to be single and doing it well. And while we don't know everything, obviously, we do want to give you the wisdom that we have learned along the way. Hopefully, it'll be some kind of tool for you that you can be like, oh yeah, me too. I totally get it. I totally understand. Oh, I struggle with that too. So that's what this series is for.
Today, we want to talk about worth. And we talk about how you define your worth. You know, a lot of people define their worth in many different ways. Their success, their career, money, job, looks, significant other, relationships. I mean, there's many ways you can define your worth that is not the right way.
And if you find your worth in those things, what happens when those things disappear? What happens when you lose your job? Or what happens when someone you love says something hurtful to you? What happens is all of a sudden, your worth, which was founded on them or that status or that thing, your worth crumbles beneath.
Absolutely.
And all of a sudden you find yourself worthless by your own definition. And personally, I had struggled with this concept big time. So I would find myself in these highs, these amazing highs, like, ah, I can conquer the world. And then all of a sudden, boom, I would plummet. And feel completely worthless and hopeless and depressed. And after some time of really seeking God about it, he spoke to me and he showed me that I had placed my worth in the idea of being married, in the concept of being loved by someone, because I didn't have those things in my life. I didn't have marriage. I didn't have a significant other. I had basically said to myself, well, if you don't have those things, then you are worthless.
And it's also important to recognize patterns, especially if we're having consistent overreactions. And I noticed that in my life personally. So if rejection was an issue for me, where I would notice that anytime rejection happened or I perceived rejection happened, that I had a over-the-top reaction. You know, so this was in romantic areas. This was in the area of guys or a husband, but this was also in all areas of my life. So I would notice that if he liked her, whoever her is, or if the guy wasn't asking me out, or if he, you know, he didn't like me and I liked him, that it was very personal. And I had to realize that there was a root there. There was a root of rejection. And I was putting my self-worth in something other than the Lord at that time.
And honestly, it doesn't have to be a relationship that you see these things triggered in their life. You might be jealous over the fact that someone else got the job that you wanted. You might be jealous by the fact that someone else is driving a certain car and you're not able to afford that type of car, or your living situation. You might be living with your parents and you're like, oh my gosh, I can't believe I'm in this situation. You might be struggling with these feelings. It's because you're putting your worth in your position, when in reality, your position is in Christ already. The thing about it is, if you see a pattern in your life, I definitely saw a pattern in my own life, multiple friends getting married, I struggle with a lot of jealousy. And I realized that this isn't going to go away unless I deal with it. Marriage isn't going to fix the rejection issues.
One of the best things is to be proactive.
Definitely.
You know, instead of just waiting for these things, you know, once you recognize them, you'll know what to deal with. And instead of waiting for a moment to come up, instead of waiting for a reaction, waiting for one of those things, we are proactive in reading our scriptures, declaring the word of God over our lives, fasting, seeking God and saying, search me, Lord. Show me these areas of my life where I have put my worth in anything but you. Take a moment to confront the lies.
Definitely.
For me with rejection, I've had lies in my mind such as, you're never going to be wanted. When I was 30, 2 years ago, I remember thinking I was never going to get married. No one was ever going to want me again. That I was too old. I had people tell me in my past that once you hit this age, it's too late for you. And it's just a lie.
And there are so many tools out there. I could recommend tons of books, and I'll link them below. But books that will help you renew your mind. Books that will help you pray the word over yourself. Books that will help you know what it means to fast and what are the spiritual bondages that need to break off. First and foremost, highest priority, get yourself in the Word of God. That is the thing that will transform you. One of the major factors here, though, is that you have to have a willingness to change.
Oh, yes.
You might be stuck in this rut for 10 years where you feel like, I've struggled with the rejection for 10 years straight and it won't go away. Well, okay, but now's the time to change. When I was going through that journey of really uprooting that rejection out of my life, I prayed two different scriptures over myself, I mean, multiple times a day, out loud. Be diligent, be out loud with the word of God. And those scriptures were in Psalm 51, create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. And the other one was from Psalm 139, and it's search me thoroughly, O God, know my ways, try and test me. Basically giving God the go-ahead to say, let me just get to those little nasty parts inside your heart, let me pull them away. Something to hang on to as you go from this video is that people and the love that they give you should be wonderful reminders of your value. They shouldn't be your value. Have you met worth himself? You know, you will not ever feel truly worthy until you actually hear the voice of the one who is worthy speaking worthiness over you.
So good.
Now, the Bible says that worthy is the Lamb, and that around his throne, angels are crying, worthy, worthy, holy, holy. He is the one that is worthy. And he has given to us worthiness as well. He has imparted worthiness to us. The moment that he got on the cross and hung there for you and said, I'm doing this for you, the moment that he was raised to life and said, I've given you all power through my resurrection, that was him saying, you are worthy. Yes. We were raised with Christ and seated in heavenly places. Right now, you are seated with Christ in heavenly places now. You're not on this earth groveling like a little worm, trying to figure it out. You are worthy now.
Yes.
But again, you won't understand that. You won't believe that until you have the voice of the Lord whisper that over you, even shout it to you. And so now's the time that we want to speak that over you. Yes. We want to pray that over you. We want to believe that God is going to whisper something into you.
Yes.
We want to believe that the word of God is going to come to life and you're going to realize, I am worthy because he's called me worthy.
Yes.
Not because anybody else has called me in. Not because I'm married or I'm not, or I have this job or I have this car or I have this status or I have all these likes on Instagram. Not because any of those things, but simply because he has called you worthy.
Yes.
And so right now, God, I speak into the lives of every single person who is watching this video, and I declare open ears.
Yes.
I declare open eyes that they would see and they would hear the promises of God, that the voice of the Lord declaring worthiness would be in their ears, that they would hear it and that something would come alive with them. Deep calls unto deep in this moment, God. Spirit calls unto spirit. Father, I pray that you would break off the lies of rejection. Break off the hindrances of their mind, God, where they have felt that their worthiness comes from something or someone else, God. In Jesus' name, may they understand and know fully the power of the cross, the power of the resurrection that lives within them. In Jesus' name. It has been amazing getting to talk to you about this. We love you so much. I know that we don't know many of you personally, but it is truly our heart's desire that we get to speak life into you, that we share this journey together. So comment below if there's anything that you need prayer for.
And if you'd like to see more of these videos, then hit the subscribe button below.
We're going to go more in depth as the weeks go on about these subjects of midlife-ish, unmarried, and making the most of it. Now, there was a blog that I wrote a couple years ago that was featured in Relevant, and we've put it in the link below. So if you want to see more of that, take a look at it. But those are the topics that we're going to be getting into in our next videos.
All right, well, we'll see you next time.